Hi, I am Dr. Kumar Parth. I am surgical gastroenterologist practicing in Bangalore for more than last 15 years. This video basically I made to know the general public, general population, what are the common gastrointestinal problem where you are supposed to meet a gastroenterologist. So without wasting time, I'll start from the basic upper gastrointestinal system. The most common day-to-day problem what we are facing is gastritis. Gastritis means excess production of the acid in the stomach, right? What are the symptoms? I mean, you have a upper abdominal pain, which sometimes goes in the back. You have a acid regurgitation. The food or acid comes in the mouth sometime. You have an abnormal chest pain. You feel like there's a pain for heart. Sometimes the pain on the right side of the chest, sometimes on the left side of the chest, sometimes you have pain over the hand, sometimes neck tightness, breathlessness and headache. These all are symptoms of gastritis. There are non-specific symptoms of gastritis, which sometimes you have a recurrent cough and cold and you feel like you have a sore throat, you have a throat infection, but the cause is actually an acid reflux. That time you should seek a gastroenterologist advice. The other common symptoms like what I keep seeing is fatty liver. Moment you get an ultrasound report saying you have a fatty liver, you get panic. So fatty liver is nothing. There's an excess deposition of fat inside the liver. How much fat you have gained, you see over your tummy, same amount of fat get deposited in the liver. That time you should seek a gastroenterologist because it can be a fatality. Go in the liver failure called cirrhosis, right? There are certain pain abdomen, chronic pain abdomen. When a patient comes to me and they say the pain doesn't go off, it keep happening sometimes around the belly button, sometimes nearby right, left, lower abdomen. If the pain sustains for more than a week, definitely you should meet a gastroenterologist because it can be because of ulcer, it can be because of a partial obstruction, it can be because of infection. And we keep dealing with the GI symptoms, so we know better how to deal and what exact investigation you need, whether what treatment you need. Other most common complaint which I keep seeing is constipation. Any constipation means you are not passing motion daily. You are passing maybe weekly twice or weekly once. And any newly started constipation should always be evaluated. It can be because of an obstruction. It can be because of a slow bowel movement. That's when definitely you should meet a gastroenterologist and we need to fix it. Second thing is blood in the stool. When you pass blood in the stool, most common cause it may be a pus when it is a painless bleeding. It can be a fissure, a tear in the anal canal, which can be again it lead to pain as well as bleeding. It never lead to tremendous bleeding how the piles has. The third common cause of nowadays what we are seeing blood in the stool is a colitis, and most common is ulcerative colitis or non-specific colitis. Definitely you need to visit a gastroenterologist to know a proper diagnosis, whether the bleeding where you are seeing blood in the motion because of piles, fissure or a rectal ulcer, or in an aged population many times we see cancer also. You should not delay, you should meet a gastroenterologist. So this all basic I try to cover. Cause of pain abdomen are vary, like it may be a gallbladder stone, it may be a kidney stone, it may be a pancreatitis, it may be a bowel obstruction or infection in the bowel. So when we come to know, when patient tells us the history and the site of the pain, we come to know which part of the abdomen is getting affected and we try to solve that one. So hope this video should bring you, bring within notice when you are supposed to meet a gastroenterologist and will fix your problem. Thanks a lot.